Hi there. I just realised I'd forgotten to show you how I do my side seams. So I'm going to sew my side seam and then I'm going to show you how to do the stretch to a needle hem. So for the side seam, again, you've got your ballpoint stretch or your Microtex needle in, and I'm putting my machine back to my zigzag stitch, and I'm taking my zigzag stitch right down to about 1.5 and 1.5 length. So the other time I kind of took it to 1.75, but it's definitely 1.5 width and 1.5 length. Now I'm not using the super stretch stitch on the sewing machine today, it's just the zigzag, because I don't need to do that. I use the super stretch stitch when I'm doing lycra for leotards or togs or tights, but I don't find I need to do it for my garments that I wear. So I'm just doing, usually it's like a 1 centimeter seam, so that's what I'm doing on my side seam. And as I said before, you do not need to worry about overlocking, because your machine, your fabric doesn't need to overlock, it doesn't fray. All right, so right side to right side. Now, once again, I'm using the ballpoint or stretch lace pins, and if you are pinning it, because I've only got a little sample here, but if it was my full garment, and when I did do my full garment, I made sure that my pins were horizontal, not vertical. If they have it vertical, then you will still walk your fabric down. So if you want to use a walking foot, you certainly could do it. This garment, actually, I didn't make with it to show you it worked fine without it. Okay, so just small zigzag, needle stop down on, so that when you stop, the fabric won't move, and you can rearrange the fabric and it will not stretch between pin and pin. Okay, now once you've done that, you can either just give it a very light press, because it will just sit nice and flat. What I did was I just pressed my seams one side, okay, so I just pressed it one side. I didn't open the seams up or anything, because it is a small zigzag. Now when I turn the hem up, what I do is I just turn it up to the right side, making sure that it's at least 1 inch at least, okay? And when I pin so my pins are on the right side, because I'm going to be stitching on the right side. So at least 1 inch, and you never stitch any closer to your folded edge than about 3/4 of an inch with knit fabric, and you won't have any problem with it making a horrible curly edge. So what that does is your knit fabric, if you sew too close to the edge, it starts fluting like this. So if you have a nice depth to your hem, you won't have a problem. So I'm going to do this on about 3/4 of an inch. So make sure that you've got your seam, whichever way you're doing it, make sure that that seam is nice and flat. So what I do is I flatten it with my finger or press it, and then I put a pin in there. Okay, so it's held. Now I'm going to take out my single needle, and I'm going to put on my stretch twin needle, and this is a 4 millimeter stretch twin needle. You can get a 2.5 millimeter stretch needle, but most of the garments you buy would have a lovely 4 millimeter twin needle on them. Okay, so whoops. So I'm going to pop one of those in, and I'll tell you something funny. This has got 4 millimeter twin needle in, it's got a 2.5 needle in it. So I'm doing a 2.5 needle, but I normally would do a 4 millimeter twin needle. That's quite funny, I must have put it away in the wrong packet. So what I have to do is I need to have a separate reel of thread. So I'm going to just gently take that out. I'm going to get my other reel of thread. And so I now have 2 metricine threads. I find the end of it. And me personally, this is how I do it. I don't do that. I get both my reels, both my threads. Just try and find the ends. There they are. So both my threads, and I just keep them separated with my finger, and I go into here, and there's a little tension dial, and I put one on one side and one on the other. So when I separate it here, they're both going to go one side on one of the tension and one on the other. Now I do that so that when I pull it down, I'm going to separate them again at the needles. So what you do is you pull one on the right hand side and you put in the right needle, and one on the left hand side and in the left needle. Just make sure I've got the same amount so it doesn't twist. So I'm keeping them separate, and I'm taking out my Microtex needle and putting it back in your packet so you don't forget that that's your Microtex needle. And one of my ladies said she turns her needles upside down so she knows that she's used that particular one. But I usually just put it on the right hand side and I know that's the one I've already used. So the stretch twin needle works the same as an ordinary needle. It's got a single place to put it up and it's always flat to the back. So I think that's funny that that is a 2.5 needle, but I would normally use a 4. So I'm just going to go up and around here, keeping them separate with my fingers, and it's in all the right places. And then in behind here, and you can't use your needle threader. Okay, so now I'm putting one on the right hand side and one on the left hand side. Now if you put your foot back on and you put your foot down, where you go to thread your needle by hand, you can see clearly because the foot has got a white bar in it. And a lot of people, when I was telling them, didn't even realize. But Benina, if I show you on this one, they have put a white bar on the back of all your feet so that when you put your foot down, if you need to thread it manually, you can. It's quite clever. So I don't know if you've ever noticed that on your machine before, but it's there. So I just thought I'd point that out because some of my ladies hadn't realized that. Now I'm not going to thread. I was going to thread the one I've just threaded back through the other needle. That would have been very interesting for you. Might have been a wally of the week. So I'm just going to thread that needle. So that is your two twin needles. Your two needles of your twin needle threaded. And then just put them under there. So you've got one bobbin and your twin needles. And just pop those threads in behind that little guide to hold it all. There we are. And this is why you really, really need a clean machine, because all of these things, if you try and do them with a dirty machine, won't work. So I'm putting my fold of my fabric on my 5/8 seam mark. That is 3/4 of an inch, and I know I won't have any problem with my fabric. Now, I'm going to put it on straight sewing, and I'm going to put it on 3 length. So what it does is it does a twin needle on top, and underneath it will do a zigzag. So it will still be able to stretch around your hips. Okay, make sure you just hold those threads so you don't get a horrible mess at the beginning. Start sewing. Again, needle down works beautifully on the stretch fabric. Here's me saying that and something's not quite right. I can hear it. Could you hear that little noise? That means that something's not right. Now don't pull your twin needle. If that ever happens, do not pull your twin needle. So somehow there's a little thread got caught, and you cut your bobbin thread, take that out. Then, it's good that this happens so you can actually see what to do and not freak out. Then you need to take your shuttle system out, because if you don't take that out, the threads get caught around this hook. And then when you try to release them, you're going to damage your twin needle. And they're worth $9. So then do that, and then you can lift this up. See how it comes out easily? So you just need to make sure. And it's somewhere here, because I can feel that it's not one of these threads. I can see it. I can see exactly what it is. This thread here, one of these threads is twisted. I'm just going to just take that off a bit and see which one it is. So I might just unthread it to show you. So these things can happen to anybody, as you can see, and I'm just going to very carefully take it backwards. I can feel it in here. I can feel where it's caught. And I was being so careful too, threading it, wasn't I? And it backfired. So sometimes I should have probably pulled it to see if it was releasing. Just pull it gently. Just keep pulling it gently to make sure. I'll cut that thread, and then I can pull it out, okay? It's this one here I can feel. So make sure you take them completely out and start again. don't carry on stitching because it will only get worse. Okay, so we'll do that again. One on that side, one on that side. You can do them separately if you like. Okay, foot down. Hello. Hi ladies, I was just saying hello to somebody. They were going to turn the alarm on, so that's why I was saying hello. I'm not talking to myself. So now I'm just going to thread my twin needle and then I'll put my shuttle back in. Okay, now my needles need to be at the right position so you can actually see the little tiny hole. It's pretty teeny tiny. And then the other one. And then I'll put my shuttle system back in, and then I'll put my bobbin case system back in. So then I know that everything's in its rightful place, and make sure those threads aren't twisted this time. There we go. I think, yep, that looks good. So now I'm gonna put this back in, and the easiest way to do that is just tilt your machine back so you can see, especially when you've got your sew table on. So it just sits in place. It doesn't stay there. You just lean it back, sit it in place, click your shuttle system in, and put your bobbin case back in. Okay? And to make sure that it's working right, before you start again, put your foot down, do one rotation of your twin needle, lift your bobbin thread up, lift your foot up, and if you pull it, it should pull freely. Then you know you've got it all right. I should have done that at the beginning, and then I wouldn't have had a problem. I thought I heard something, and I thought, no, it's fine, but it definitely, you could hear it. So now I'll just start from here because it's not my garment. Actually, it's pulled out anyway, hasn't it? I pulled the threads out. You just pull one thread and it pulls the threads out when one's loose. So now I'll go back onto my 3/4 inch marking, which is 5/8. And I will stitch that again. So this time, holding my thread, that sounds a whole lot nicer. And it's a good lesson because we all think, oh, we'll just pull that thread out and it'll be fine. Start from scratch, redo it, especially when you're working with 3 threads. Now, when you get to here, needle down, take your pin out, coming along to here, needle down, take your pin out. Now what I normally do here is I use a sewing gauge or something. I can use my scissors. I lift my foot up and I flatten that seam out. See how I'm holding it both sides? Lift it up, flatten that seam out so that I don't get my seam moving when I'm stitching over it. Okay. So just needle down, take your pins out as you go, and then you're going to use your duckbill scissors to trim the back away. Needle up, foot up, and pull it and cut it. Now when I finish the bottom part of my top, I overlap it and backstitch it. Okay, so now I'm going to turn it over to the wrong side, around this way. And I'm going to trim it back with my duckbill scissors to my zigzag stitch. It's a very, very neat finish. You don't get any excess fabric. I love it, in fact. It's very neat and tidy. And I use it a lot. Okay, so there you can see your lovely knit finish. And the best part is, it stretches and it won't pop. So that has done a zigzag stitch underneath, a twin needling on top, and it stretches around your body, so it will not pop. So the definitely want to use a stretch twin needle on stretch fabrics. Now I'm just going to quickly show you my mistake on my top because it's really important so you don't make the mistake. So this looks really lovely until I turn sideways. So I cut this out at night, and when I sewed it, I sewed the back round the wrong way. So this back fabric here is actually the wrong side, and this is the right side, so this is darker and this is lighter. Now this garment, I decided, because the pattern has this, but I decided I would use a cotton, polycotton fabric to go down the back. And it's not quite the right blue, but it will work. Because what I've done is I've covered the buttons with a bit of the polycotton and a little bit of the lace fabric. So it's going to have buttonholes all the way down here. These ones are going to undo here, and these are going to be false all the way down there. So I can just undo the first four button and buttonholes and take it off. So I haven't done that yet, obviously, but just to show you. So this is just polycotton, and I use my overlock stitch on my sewing machine. Two bits of fabric, a little bit of interfacing, right sides together, and I pop that on the back. So I think it's going to be quite a useful top. So because I've made this little mistake here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut some of my flowers and applique the designs down. So I will say to you, I will try and have it done for next time and wear it to show you, because I really, really like the top. I think it's very pretty. Okay, so that is the highlight top. Now I'm going to show you something completely, completely different. So I'm going to cut my threads, and I'm going to pull these out, and I'm going to take my bobbin thread out, and I'm going to take my twin needle off. Now this time, I need to use 100% cotton thread, 100% cotton fabric, and 100% cotton wadding, because I'm going to show you how to make a potato bag. Now these are for cooking potatoes in the microwave, and they are fantastic. But you could use this idea for making any sort of little pouch. But for cooking, it has to be cotton. So this is Gutermann 100% cotton thread. You just wind the bottom of the reel, and I'm going to wind a bobbin here. So it has to be cotton thread, because otherwise it will burn. And I'm going to use an ordinary needle. So I'm going to put in an 80 jeans ordinary needle. I say ordinary, but it is a jeans. So cotton thread top and bottom. And my needle. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to also use my little quilting guide. So these little quilting guides fit onto the back of your feet, and there's little screws on your back of your feet which fall off all the time. In fact, I'll use this foot because it's got it on. This is an open toe foot. The little screws in the back of the feet, and you just put your quilting guide on the back and you move it to whatever size you want. I'm going to use one of those today because I use it a lot. And you can use your ordinary foot, but I've put on the 20 foot because my ordinary foot screws fallen off. They do all the time. So sometimes it pays to tighten those screws. So I'm just putting my cotton thread on the bobbin, my cotton thread on the top. Take your piece of sticker off so it doesn't get caught on your thread, and thread it ordinarily. And if your needle doesn't work as good as mine does, get it fixed. They are brilliant. A lot of people say, oh, I can't use the needle threader. Bring it in, let me check it, get it fixed if it's not working properly. Okay, so here's my fabric I'm using. I've got 100% cotton fabric that I love the look of. I've got a cotton fabric to bind the top and bottom because I like to make it a bit neater. I have got a little bit of the fabric to make a loop. And I have got a cotton wadding. And I have got a piece of calico. Okay, so I'm going to put my calico aside for now. And I'm going to put my fabric on top of my cotton wadding, like that, and like that. And I'm just going to rule a line and just do a couple of quilting lines. So I'm just going to rule a line across here, like that. And I'm just going to rule a line over the other way as well. just so I've got a couple of little lines to follow. And this is just a Trick Master. So this Trick Master is a pen that after a while it will just fade away. I don't need to wash it out. Always test it on a bit of fabric first, but and don't iron onto it, okay? So it will just disappear. Okay, it's very handy. So I don't really need my walking foot because I'm only doing a small garment and I'm not going to do a fancy stitch. I'm just going to lift up my quilting guide and leave it on three length, cotton thread top and bottom, cotton fabric, cotton wadding, okay? And a lady came into the shop and her friend had given her one of these from America, and it had burnt in the microwave. And we had a look and it definitely did not have cotton fabric. And then I Googled and I saw that there was quite a few people who had made these, and definitely the answer is cotton, cotton and cotton. So cotton wadding, cotton fabric and cotton thread. And that ruling line that you've done is just a guide. So I go one way and then I go the other way. So I've just got done like a crisscross, cross hatch, and then I'm going to use my guide and do two more rows. Okay, it's just to hold it in place. I find it easier to do it. So I do utilize everything that I have on my machine. So now what I do is I just run my quilting guide along my previous stitching line, and then I watch my quilting guide, not my stitching line, and that's what I follow. So I'm looking at my quilting line and my guide is following that last lot of stitching, okay? And that is how I get my lines nice and even. Control, and I'm going to go back this way and do this line. So you just look at your quilting guide. Needle down is brilliant. Let's whip across here. And if you haven't followed your guide, your first line very well, it doesn't matter because it disappears. Okay. So you're not doing much quilting, it's just to hold those bits together. Okay. And what I did on my one, I just did a little triangle in here, so you can just stitch a little triangle in here. And all I did was I just counted. So I just went like this. I went, put my needle stop down, and from here, I just counted 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, needle down, and then up to here, so it's a right angle. 10. And again, and I just did a few of those just for fun. Just so I had some quilting rows. It wasn't any reason, rhyme or reason, I just did. But that's what I do. And then backstitch. Okay, so I just did a few of those on the end. I haven't got time now, but that's all I do. Sometimes when I just want to add a little feature, I'll do something like that. Okay, and you can see the quilting through there. All right, so that is how you do the first part. It's just a little bit of quilting to hold your fabrics together. You're going to be washing it a bit because it's going to be cooking potatoes, believe it or not. So you now have that all quilted, pretend that's all quilted. You have your little tag here, so you can just simply sew that in a, you can top stitch it or you can turn it through. I'll just top stitch it because I couldn't find my loop turner, and so I'll just do a little narrow seam. I just put fold them into the middle and then fold them in half. No big deal, it's only a little tag. Just so that in my kitchen I can hang it up. I quite like to hang things up. Or you might have somewhere to hang it, so it's quite nice. So hold your thread and then just start sewing. I certainly don't pin anything like this, just use my needle stop down. And yes, I would normally press that. just whip across there. It's just a quick little tag. Okay. So next step is we're going to put our calico underneath. So we're going to have a layer of calico, and we're going to have a layer of wadding, and we're going to have a layer of our fabric. Okay. Then we're going to bind this edge. So I'm just using this binding, and I just put a top stitch on the right side, so I'm going to put that onto the wrong side. Just had to think what I did there. And you're putting all your four layers. So you've got your top layer, you've got your calico, your wadding and your calico and your binding. And you're putting all those together. Okay, I'll just do it on this side so you can see it. So that's all I'm doing, very, very easy. And it's about a quarter inch seam. Now I say about because it's not drastic for this. You don't have to be so accurate because it's only a potato bag. You're cooking potatoes in it. Don't stress about being too accurate. And yes, you would pin yours. Okay? And when I'm pinning it again, for this one, the pins go vertical, horizontal, not vertical. So always with the pins like this. Okay, so you're getting all your layers. And it stops it from stretching from one pin to the next. But this is a very cheaty, quick way of putting a binding on. Because I'm going to top stitch it on the right side. Okay, then number 10 foot, as I showed you before. And this time I'm going to actually stitch on the binding. So this binding's going to come all the way over here. So I'm going to trim that seam back to my fabric. You'll spend a bit more time. I usually use the cutter actually. I don't know why I'm using scissors. I normally just put it over on the cutting board and cut it. I'll do the other one like that so you can see it. And then this comes all the way over. So it's the opposite to the blouse. This was the wrong side, this is now the right side. And see, this is coming right over. And this time I'm actually stitching on the binding. So I'll put a coloured pin on so you can see. So I'm actually stitching onto the binding where the pins are. Okay, so it's a little bit different because I'm top stitching onto the binding. But it's exactly the same method, and it's 2.5 inches wide, not 2.25 inches wide as the binding was on the knit top. But it's quite good because you're reinforcing the same type of binding and you're using it for a craft item. So it's actually quite good. So now I'm going to put my needle position down on my fold of my binding and put my needle position 2 clicks to the right. So when I start sewing, my needle is down in my binding and my guide is running along my folded edge. Hope you can see that nice and clearly because it's very, very, very easy. So 2 clicks to the right, needle down, take your pin out, run your binding along that edge. Once you get started, away you go. Okay. So when we come back after this little break, because I think I'm running out of time, I will have sewn the other end. Oh no, I'll sew the other end with you, and I'll show you how to finish off your potato bag because you're going to love it. So I'll see you soon.